episodes that we just decided we needed to pop in here and give a little update and maybe a little
preview.
There you go, that's a good one. Of what we've got coming, because we're just so excited to jump into the New Testament next year. All this that's going on with Come Follow Me is just really exciting, and we are excited to be a part of it with you.
There's a scripture that comes to mind that I've thought of quite a bit since President Nelson announced this new initiative to focus more on home-centered church and home-centered worship. In the beginning of Acts, right after the Savior departs, the apostles are left with this command to preach the gospel to all the world, but not really a whole lot of instruction on how to do it. And so they organize what I think might be the first church meeting, at least the first one led by the apostles. And this is where they hold it. This is in verse 13 in Acts chapter 1. When they were, well, I guess verse 12 first. Then returned they unto Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is from Jerusalem a Sabbath day's journey. And when they were come in, they went up into an upper room, where abode both Peter and James, John and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James the son of Alphaeus, and Simon Zelotes, and Judas the brother of James. In other words, the first place that the apostles met was in a home. In fact, all throughout the New Testament, whenever the word church is used, it is pretty exclusively used to denote a home church. In fact, they were even called house churches. You can find references to them in Paul's writings when he writes to specific individuals who led these house churches, where people would gather in someone's home to partake of the sacrament, to study, to worship, to praise, and to commune with each other. And so what President Nelson announced in this home-centered church really isn't something new as much as it is a restoration of something that existed a long time ago. And we're excited for what this is going to do for our family, and we are really excited for how we can be of service to anyone else that's listening in getting you excited for teaching your family.
One of the things that our podcast that we've always wanted, that we actually said at the beginning of every podcast, was that this was a resource to help you get more out of your study. And listen, I'm not saying it at the beginning of the podcast. I don't remember it. Say it, Zach, the beginning.
To help you passionately teach what you're learning.
There you go. So one thing that we have just, that I feel very strongly about, is that when you find out your why you're personally studying scriptures, and when you have an experience in the scriptures, connect with God through the scriptures and gain a testimony of the Savior through the scriptures, that you can't help but want to share that. And so our goal has always been to help you be a small part of that, maybe be a resource for you to help you feel that passion that makes you want to teach it, and especially to your family, especially those close to you.
In fact, there's something I've learned about teaching. It's that the success of any teaching usually happens before you step into the classroom. It comes as you prepare yourself to teach. If you go into a classroom and you are not fired up about what you're teaching, about why you're teaching, and about how this could make a difference to those that you're teaching, then no matter how skilled you are as an educator, you fall flat. And so what our podcast does, or what we hope it will do for you in this new year, is get you fired up and excited about your personal study, so that when you sit down with, I don't know, someone else in your family, your husband, your wife, your children, or if you're on your own, this is just a resource for individual study.
In small groups. Or in your Sunday school class too.
That this fires you up. As it says in the Old Testament, Jeremiah has this fire in his bones that he can't not teach the gospel. We want this to be that for you, and that's what we're going to focus on this upcoming year.
And if you're not there yet, we hope that you can feel this and that maybe we can be a part of that for you, a resource. I also wanted to read, nothing more powerful than hearing kind of the purpose from the words from the mouth of a prophet. So this is from last conference, from one of President Nelson's talks. He says, "The new home-centered church-supported integrated curriculum has the potential to unleash the power of families as each family follows through conscientiously and carefully to transform their home into a sanctuary of faith. I promise that as you diligently work to remodel your home into a center of gospel learning, over time, Your Sabbath days will truly be a delight. Your children will be excited to learn and to live the Savior's teachings, and the influence of the adversary in your life and in your home will decrease. Changes in your family will be dramatic and sustaining. I kind of got the chills when I listened to that just the other day, and just to hear those promises that really that's what can happen.
So get ready, get studying. Our first episode of the season will come out on January 1st. Usually our episodes come out on Monday.
January 2nd.
January 2nd.
Didn't we say we weren't going to do it on the New Year's Day?
Oh, yeah. January 2nd. There you go.
It'll on the pop first up. Or the subscribe, second. Subscribe so you're ready to get started in the new year. We'll be back soon.